Virgin of Zapopan, Patroness, Generala and Pacifier, Queen of the State of Jalisco, located in the western coast of Mexico. She's also called the Pilgrim or the Traveler Virgin because she goes out to look for her sons, and she spreads her cloak beyond the national borders, calling those who emigrated and now return. This is the reason why, year after year since 1734, the return to her shrine in Zapopan becomes a feast to celebrate the cultural identity and the faith of millions of people that have arrived to Guadalajara and Zapopan in order to carry out la llevada, the carrying, as the ritual cycle is popularly known. It starts in May and concludes on October the 12th, with mariachis, ceremonial dancing, incense and prayers, a symbiosis that shows the pre-Hispanic past and the mark of 300 years of colonization.
La Virgen de Zapopan es la patrona de los tapatíos. Para la mayoría de los que viven en la zona conurbada de Guadalajara, pues siempre está de parte de su formación religiosa este asunto de la devoción a la Virgen.
Y que la imagen de la Virgen primero fue culto propio de los indígenas. Fue el trayectorio de seguridad, se la dejó a los indígenas. Y él se fue. Y los indígenas que empezaron todo su proceso cultual a la imagen.
Es la única tradición del periodo del virreinato que todavía subsiste hasta nuestros días. Y es lo que le ha dado identidad religiosa y cultural en gran parte a lo que es la ciudad de Guadalajara y posteriormente lo que se conoció en algún tiempo como la exvilla maicera, que es este municipio de Zapopan.
This complex ritual is a result of mixed popular religious expressions, which are shown on the day of the Romería itself, through the massive participation of the community, reaching more than 2 million people, as much as through the one-year planning of each visit the Virgin do in chapels, hospitals, prisons, markets, factories and schools, all supported by ecclesiastical and governmental authorities, who facilitate and coordinate the event as well. The passage of the Virgin is guarded and accompanied by the Guardia de Honor, an association of 500 devotees in which the Guardia Regia stands out, an elite group dressed as the Swiss Guard of the Vatican, which escort the Virgin through special visits as the Chapala Lake, the mass of the renovation of the sponsorship as universal patroness of the Archdiocese of Guadalajara, celebrated at the emblematic Hospicio Cabañas, included in the UNESCO's World Heritage List in 1997. And on October the 12th, day of the Romería, or the Carrying, when thousands of pilgrims walk along with the image of the Virgin from Guadalajara's Cathedral to Zapopan's Basilica.
Desde el año 45 se fundó la Guardia de la Virgen de Zapopan para, por lo mismo de que se hacían muchos tumultos, mucha gente y todo, nada más inició con el grupo que era el calabrote central, que viene siendo la soga que va jalando la carroza. En aquel entonces era una carroza donde iba la imagen, y bueno, una soguita lateral que era como para hacer una valla.
Los danzantes, por ejemplo, se preparan desde 3 meses antes al evento, al 12 de octubre. En diversos barrios de la ciudad de Guadalajara preparan sus bailes, preparan sus trajes que ese día estrenan precisamente.
Nosotros hacemos nuestras mismas vestiduras.
Y también los diversos gremios se preparan con mucho tiempo de anticipación, con 2 meses o 1 mes, a participar en el evento.
To the sound of drums and to the hoot of shell musicians, thousands of dancers join this ritual, accompanying Nuestra Señora de la Expectación de Zapopan in her habitual route made since 280 years ago along the ritual cycle. There, the so-called groups of conquest prevail. Also, the concheros, lanceros, aztecas, sonajeros and matachines, with all its variants. Some wearing cotton cloth garb and headdresses made of colorful bird feathers, as pheasants are peacock, and garlands of rattles around the ankles. Some others wearing Apache costumes, each of them showing both a unique identity, yet diverse, but a same tradition transmitted to them from their ancestors, dance incessantly for the Virgin of Zapopan. The Romería of October 12th is repeated at over 200 visits made by the Virgin through the year, including the 176 Catholic temples of the city of Guadalajara and the entire journey through the Chapala Lake. In all of those visits, the elements that made this a cultural expression are seen. The mariachi music, intangible cultural heritage of humanity, flower arcs, carpets made of alfalfa in colorful sawdust, blue and white flags, altars.
Los elementos para recibir a la Virgen en cada uno de los templos a los que visita todos los días por esta época es un poco una variación, incluso más todavía, de lo que ocurre el 12 de octubre. Es decir, el camino de alfalfa o el camino de aserrín en algunos casos, los arcos que están adornados con flores y que en la parte de arriba tienen una especie de piñatita que cuando pasa abajo la Virgen la abren, la pican y escurre el confeti.
No one doubts that she is the queen, and they treat her as such. Her tiny figure, 1,15 feet tall, contrasts with the richness and variety of her costume. Since she first arrived in Zapopan in 1530, hanging from Fray Antonio de Segovia's neck, until the 21st century, her attire has changed, and she has collected titles, badges, even several replicas of the Virgin have been made. And she has received many gifts from the devotees, her pontifical crown in 1921, her blade as Generala of the Insurgent Army of Nueva Galicia, a staff of command which identifies her as the sovereign of Jalisco State in 1821, the keys of the city, a scepter, even a golden suitcase given by the traveler agents. The solemn attire of the image, which remains in the sanctuary's niche, is according to the traditional use of the Virgins of Andalusia, of triangular shape, with a long cape, embroidered over fine fabrics, brocaded and decorated with golden threads, canutillos, and precious gemstones. A massive concentration in the Hospicio Cabañas Esplanade in Guadalajara marks the last point in the Virgin's itinerary before she comes back to her sanctuary. There, pilgrims and devotees from many places arrive, and as the night goes on, they will rise to thousands to renew their fervor and sponsorship to their Generala.
Digamos, la llevada es el culmen de todo lo que ha venido sucediendo meses atrás en todas las comunidades religiosas, ¿no?
Near the mid-morning, a 2 million people crowd is wandering along a 5 mile avenue. The Virgin of Zapopan has arrived to her basilica, and she's received with dances, chants, the constant pealing of the bells, and all forms of faith expressions. Mass media narrate the event and transmit it live. In this moment, the merging of local authorities and the people is complete. This is a faith feast, a feast of the deep-seated identity of Western Mexico. The whole community involved has joined to the request for getting this cultural element included in the UNESCO's representative list of intangible cultural heritage. Throughout several workshops, they have analyzed the advantages of this achievement. So they have foreseen and prevented the necessary safeguarding actions. Finally, they have signed their free, previous and informed consent in order to present the nomination file of La Romería of the Virgin of Zapopan as an intangible cultural heritage. They have already created a management committee for La Romería with the aim of, besides the organization itself, monitoring the safeguarding plan of this cultural element.